Hello and welcome! My name is Daria Volkova, and this channel helps you utilize Grafana to its full potential. Today, let's talk about Time Seeries visualization. It is native, the most popular Grafana visualization. I found a lot of information about this panel, yet not all great features are covered. In this video, I will fill the gap. Let's explore Time Seeries together. I have a feeling you will hear something for the first time, even you have been using Time Seeries for many years. Are you ready? Let's go! This video is a part of our Grafana Crash course. We explain how to get the most out of Grafana with examples, schemas, and code snippets. We don't exhaust you with the basics. All are welcome to take advantage of our concise materials. Meet the Time Seeries visualization. When you click the Add a Visualization button, Time Seeries is your pre-selected default. To start experimenting with it, select the Grafana data source, then query type random walk, and get your first Time Seeries visualization. If I switch to the table view, I see one of many data frame formats this panel accepts. This format has two columns. One column is called Time and the other, A Series, contains the data points. The other supported data frame format is sometimes called the wide format. It looks like a time column and then metric 1, metric 2, metric 3, and so forth, where all metrics are registered at the exact same time. The easiest way to get a glimpse of this format is via the static data source. You will need to install it first from the Grafana catalog and then add it as a data source. The only parameter to specify is the name. Mine is called static. Here in the edit mode of the Time Seeries, after I select static data source, I can add a time column and then metric 1, metric 2, and metric 3 with some dummy values. I think I'm going to enter 4 rows of data. Switch to the table view to confirm that what I get is indeed a wide format, and yes, it is. The values on the graph look smooshed because the time points are so close to each other. I can always zoom in on the timeline by click, move, release mouse action. With that, the global Grafana time range updates as well. So in the wide format, every column is considered a data series, meaning you have a line on the graph for every column. I can set up multiple axes, scroll down to the Add Field Override, then find Field with Name. I select Metric 1 and then select Axis Placement, then Right. And here the second axis appears on the right for my Metric 1. To clarify visualization further, I can add units. For that, I use Add Override property, Standard Options, Unit, and I select Square Feet. Alright, the FT square is displayed on the Y-axis labels. You can have multiple secondary axes. For that, I again click on Add Field Override button, select Field with Name, then Metric 2, Add Override property, Axis Placement, Right. Here, another Y-axis appeared. Add Override property, Standard Option, Unit, and Percent. Now I have two independent axes, one in square feet and the other in percent. Next, here in axis section, I can change the color to series. That way the color of the axis label matches the data series color. That makes interpreting the graph easier. In the graph styles section, I can modify the line interpolation from linear to smooth. Step before and step after. Using Add Field Override, I can specify line interpolation only for one data series. That way, only one line is rounded. Fill opacity will shade the space under every data series line, but I can also use the override to fill only for the series I want to, as my example shows. One of the handy features that Time Seeries has is a crosshair. To turn it on, go to the Dashboard Settings, General, and scroll down. Select Shared Crosshair, Save Dashboard. So when I hover a mouse over one graph, I have this dotted line on the other, drawn at the selected time on the first graph. I started this video with the Time Seeries supported data frames. We have already reviewed simple and wide layouts. The other supported one is multi-data frames. It is when simple and wide are multiplied. In that event, every separate data frame is called a dimension. You can switch between dimensions here in the drop-down. The data element that helps to distinguish between dimensions is often called a label or a tag. If you work with non-SQL databases like Prometheus, the label might look like this, like a collection of name and value elements. I have a video where I provide a step-by-step tutorial for a dashboard containing four time series panels, each working with multidimensional data frames. To sum up, the time series accepts a simple, wide, and multidimensional data frames. If your data source returns something different, you can always use Grafana transformations. They are designed explicitly for transforming one data layout to another. I have this video on my channel to get you started with transformations. Let's quickly review the time series visualization options. I will leave several examples here so you can see the variety for yourself. You can play with colors, opacity, you can have your visualization as lines, dots, or bars. Every property you specify could be for the whole visualization or only for the one data series. Features like visualization options are on the surface. You see them right away in the edit mode, but time series has a lot of features that don't jump at you right away. Streaming is one of those. Time series does support streaming. To check it out, add the time series panel and in the data source, select Grafana data source, then in query, live measurements. Right after, the time series looks alive. It refreshes after every new data point is added. On the dashboard, I can see that the other visualizations are not getting refreshed. Streaming works in a separate channel, which is excellent for your dashboard productivity. We have some profound examples of streaming in our documentation. It is at volkovlabs.io, Apache eCharts panel, features streaming. And yes, I understand the examples are for a different plugin, but it is as close as we got to documenting the Grafana streaming topic. You can always ask us a specific question in the comments below if something about streaming in the time series needs clarification. The next notable feature that time series supports are Grafana annotations and alerts. Annotations are comments that a user can enter to any data points after a click on the time series visualization. Type description, tags, and save. The entered annotation appears as a vertical line. If I hover, I can read the description. Alerts are embedded into the time series core, so when you are in edit mode, you have this tab next to the query and transformation tabs. You can create an alert rule for this panel. Here, many alert rules options are going to be pre-populated for you. Like in my example, I already have four queries described. Annotations and alerts are a big topic. They are often referred to as one feature. I have videos on my channel and blog posts explaining similarities and differences, providing data flow schemas and step-by-step tutorials to get everyone up to speed on the topic. Feel free to check it out. I will leave links in the description box below. Switching gears to decoupling topic. As I mentioned, time series is one of the first Grafana visualizations. It withstand many major releases and has been improved significantly over the years with no plans for retirement. However, even with the best of the panels, something always needs to be adjusted. With Grafana architecture, it has never been a problem. You can always decouple any core panel, including time series, and add as much customization as required. When you work with core panels like time series as an external panel, that allows you to include it in any Grafana version without supporting your own Grafana fork. Take a look at our repository, how we decouple time series panel. Time series is the unique and most utilized visualization panel in Grafana. Many projects combine time series with the Prometheus database. In my next video, I provide a step-by-step tutorial for the time series panel, which takes data from Prometheus. I include a touch of usability achieved by a variable panel. Like this video to show your support. Subscribe to our channel so you don't miss the Prometheus time series tutorial. Thank you for watching and see you next time.